Today we're gonna be playing Jeopardy again. That's me. Wait. I'm gonna go to the settings. No, wait. I don't want that. Game rules. Different reactions? Well, let's see. Yeah, I'm just gonna erase my profile. Anyway, so yeah, we're ready to play Jeopardy. Just need to set this up. Okay, so we want medium difficulty. I tried hard. It's way too hard. It's been boring. So yeah. Let's do this. Let's hope I win. Oh yeah, you like my signature? I figured out you could do that. It's kind of hard to, controller remote though. I'm jealous of their smooth writing. There's the host, he has no name. Ooh, cakes, yummy. Oh, nice simple one word categories. Oh, sports terms. Three. Ooh, I like that one. Victoria.
It's player one. Select letters by pointing the Wii remote on the screen and pressing the A button.
Nope.
Once you've typed in some letters, feel free to select your word from the autocomplete menu.
I'm just going to choose Victoria Nelson because...
Sorry.
Because the state is Victoria, but it said who was it named after?
Yes, player two.
Well, that's bogus, man. Screw that.
Please pick again, player two. You can enter this European city via the Puerta de Bisagra and its U.S. namesake via exit 64 on the Ohio Turnpike.
The European city?
No, that's not.
Ah, good.
Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this?
Ohio Turnpike?
Player three.
Canton?
Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response?
Don't think so. I'm not sure.
The correct response.
Toledo. Oh yeah, Toledo.
Toledo. Back to you for our next selection. Paulistas live in a large city in this large South American country.
Oh, Brazil.
Okay.
We're on the negative, but I think I'll be able to get this one. Nope. Brazil nuts. Excellent! I did it! I'm so good. I'm winning.
This country's Grand Canal ends at the port of Hangzhou.
China.
It's player one.
Let's not try pointing it, but let's just use the D-pad. China. China! Oh, I'm so smart. Mount Chad.
We're talking about Mount Kenya.
Oh, Mount Kenya.
Mm-hmm. Select again.
tennis?
Yes, player two.
It was tennis. Oh, now you're at $0. Devil's chocolate cake.
Player three.
Devil's food cake. Yeah. Still losing though.
Choose again. Player three.
Cakes.
The cheesecake
factory. Ooh.
Cheesecake
factory. I like that
recipe. Icing on this other type of cake.
Is that like red velvet cake?
Let's hear it, player three.
Carrot cake. Oh. Now it's not losing.
Schwarzwälder Kirschtorte is known by this colorful name in English.
Maybe that's red velvet.
If
I'll try it. Whoa, are you seriously kidding right now? Whoa, that sucks. Can't believe that.
Yes, player two.
Black Forest cake? That's a thing? Never even heard of that. Oh, wow.
Player two.
I am irate right now.
This aluminum cake pan that sounds like a baseball play was invented by H. David Dahlquist in the early 1950s.
Aluminum cake pan? Or I don't know.
Here's the correct response. Buns.
Oh, wow.
Again.
Okay.
As its name suggests, a trompe l'oeil cake is one designed to deceive this sense.
The ears?
Fire two. Good for you.
Aw, dang it. Oh, that's
Andy.
Golf.
Okay, player one.
Dum, 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 dum. Get there. Yeah. All right, here. I did it. Oh, I'm so smart.
Again, player one. Bomb, backfield, blitz.
Football. TB. Oh wait, I missed one.
Yes.
Dang.
Player one, you pick again, please. Let's get Kelly's assistance.
Ooh, we need Kelly's assistance.
Gully and batsman are turned to in this court.
It's cricket. Sure.
Yes, player one.
I need to take the lead here. Crime and Punishment. Oh, I'm so happy.
We return to you, player one. Fletch. Quiver.
Oh, that's like archery, right? Ooh,
player
he's quick.
Sorry.
Equestrian. No.
Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response?
Yes. Me.
It's player one.
I better get this. It's $1,000 clue. Wow. This is big brain time, everyone. I have a big brain. I'm so smart.
In chapter 52 of this novel, a boisterous crowd is gathering for Fagin's execution.
Fagin? Who's that? Oh, I chose literature? Bro, I should not have. I have no clue.
Here's what we want. Oliver Twist.
Oh, it's Oliver Twist.
You get to pick again, player one.
Whatever. Parsons.
When you're feeling blue, dream. That's the thing to do. Dream.
Preposition? I don't know. That's like those things.
Okay, player three.
No. Oh, now, no.
Any other takers?
Well, I guess it's a noun, but it's not really what they're looking for. See, I told you. Yeah, I need to know. It's triangles.
One in every six known bird species makes its home in this rainforest.
I suppose the Amazon, right?
Let's hear it, player one.
Oh, I got it. Let's go. Well, we still have not gotten a daily double for this round.
Got one of these odorous animals,
still up there.
Known as a bull cat, as a pet? Call your humane society to make sure it's legal.
A skunk?
Yes, player two.
What is skunk? Yak.
Okay, player two.
Smile with him. Haha. Good.
Anyone else?
Oh, he wants to try Mastodon. Amazing.
Player three, back to you. Dox.
Okay.
As in Dachshund.
See, I wouldn't know because German's weird.
Player two.
Badger.
You got it.
Ooh. Alright.
You get to pick again.
I should know that's not alright. What am I saying?
19th century author, known for writing about a venerable mansion with seven acutely peaked gables.
All the literature, bro. That's
it's
old stuff. What was that? Who's the author of the Jungle Book?
Here's the correct response. Rudyard Kipling.
Oh, yeah, that'd be...
Choose again. Player three.
Oh, well, at least he got the daily double. He only has $200.
Player three. Your last player.
1,000, yeah. That makes sense. It's the highest possible.
Novels with biblical titles include Jane Hamilton's The Book of Ruth. And Tony Morrison's Song of Him.
I think he's gonna get it wrong.
Good.
Oh, looks like I'm the one who got it wrong.
Back to you for our next selection. Even Grendel with
James
Heaney's new translation of the Anglo-Saxon epic about this title mute.
No, I don't know.
Here's what we were looking for. Beowulf.
Ooh, okay. Of speech.
Rodney Dangerfield said, when I was born, I was so ugly, the doctor slapped my mother.
So it's adjective, right?
Okay, player one.
Adjective. Oh, look at that. How smart am I, alright? I'm winning.
Again.
Set in kind of weird.
Yes.
Well, that's a purpose of it? For all I don't know.
We return to you, player three. We know you're very smart, but are you smart enough to know? Very. Here's what we want. An adverb.
An adverb? But it doesn't end with L-Y. Yeah, how is it an adverb?
So when you're happy, hooray, or sad, awe, or frightened, eek, or mad.
Interjection.
Oh.
Player 2 is going first? Oh, he takes second place. Oh, that's cool. Anyway, we're going to stop it here.